So friends, I welcome you back to my studio at YouTube. I am Professor GN Purohit from the Department of Veterinary Gynecology and Obstetrics, College of Veterinary and Animal Sciences, Rajasthan University of Veterinary and Animal Sciences, Bikaner, Rajasthan, India. And today we talk something about the camel reproduction and infertility. Now friends, the camelids have been divided into the New World camelids, which include the guanaco, the llama, the alpaca and the vicuña, whereas it has been further divided into the Old World camelids, which includes the dromedary camel or the Arabian camel with the one hump, and the Bactrian camel. One of them is the Bactrian camel which is domesticated, and another one is the wild Bactrian camel again with two humps. So the Bactrian camel, Camelus bactrianus, is located in Central Asia, entirely domesticated, weighs from 300 to 1000 kg, whereas the wild Bactrian camel, Camelus ferus, is located in Central Asia and is entirely wild. This weighs from 300 to 820 kg. Then the dromedary or the Arabian camel, the Camelus dromedarius, is located in South Asia and Middle East, is entirely domesticated. It weighs between 300 to 600 kg. Then the llama, these are the South American camelids, and it weighs from 130 to 200 kg. The guanaco is located in South America, weighs about 90 kg. The alpaca weighs from 48 to 84 kg. And the vicuña, South American, located in the South American Andes, and weighs from 35 to 65 kg. So again, these are the picture of the Bactrian camel, as well as the Bactrian domesticated, the Bactrian wild, and the dromedary camel. These are the pictures of the South American camelids, the llama, alpaca, guanaco. Now, when we talk of camels, first let us discuss about the reproductive anatomy of female camels. The ovaries of the camels are dorsoventrally flattened, here you can see, and slightly convex in camel heifers. They are suspended by the mesovarium. They are enclosed in the ovarian bursa. They weigh from 2 to 5 grams and their length is from 2.5 to 6 centimeter. This is a entire genitalia of a camel to show that the ovaries are located in the ovarian bursa. These are two uterine horns. This is the cervix. Again, a abatoid derived genitalia showing that one of the uterine horns of the camel is longer. The left uterine horn is always longer than the right uterine horn. And the camel genitalia are Y-shaped. The cyclic cell is absent in non-mated camels, and anovulatory follicles then turn into hemorrhagic, which are 25 to 90 mm in non-bred camels. Here you can see the hemorrhagic follicles, which are peculiar to the camel only. The cell formation, it occurs 24 to 48 hours after mating, and there is a slow development, and then there is an early death, 6 to 9 days. The regression takes place in 8 to 12 days following infertile mating. The follicles ovulate. The size of the follicles that ovulate in camels varies from 9 mm to 20 mm. Any follicle which is beyond 20 mm, it converts into large anovulatory follicle of 25 to 90 mm. And these are present on the ovaries of 30 to 50% of non-bred female camels. the uterine end of the oviduct. The isthmus is well developed, it's long and tortuous, 17 to 22 centimeters in long, in length. Then the uterus, as I said earlier, is T or Y shape. The left uterine horn is longer. The uterine horns are bicornuate, present at the brim of the pelvic cavity. Left horn is longer in pluriparous females, but both the uterine horns are similar in size in primiparous females. The cervix is soft with longitudinal folds, 3 or 4 in number. The consistency of the cervix does not differ with that of the uterus, which makes it difficult to identify by transrectal palpation. The cervix projects caudally in the vaginal cavity from forming a fornix of 1 to 1.5 centimeter. The cervical canal presents longitudinal folds. Here you can see these are the longitudinal folds, which extend on annular muscular projections and form the cervical rings. The external cervical orifice is surrounded by 1 to 2 circular indented rings of the cranial part of the mucosa of the vagina. Here you can see here. The vagina is long, 30 centimeter, with 2 vestibular glands on the lateral walls. It contains many longitudinal folds. The vulva opens below the anus and the clitoris is small. There are 4 teats in the mammary glands of the camel. And then there is a speciality that there is an extra fetal membrane known as the epidermal membrane, 1 to 2 mm thick, attached to the fetus at lips, nostrils, anus, vulva, prepuce, foot pad and umbilicus. The exact function of this extra fetal membrane is not known, yet presumed to be playing a role of protecting the fetus from jerks. Camels are seasonally polyestrous. Puberty occurs at 3 to 4 years at around 400 kg of weight. The breeding seasons in camels are seasonal breeders and they breed during the time of the year when days are short. Here you can see in Egypt, the breeding season extends from December to May. In India, it extends from November to March. In Pakistan, from December to March. And then in Kenya, it has been reported that the breeding season is continuous. In Somalia, Saudi Arabia, in Somalia again, it's May to June and October to December. In Saudi Arabia, it's December to March. In Sudan, it's March to August. And in the United Arab Emirates, November to April. So you can see in the African continents, Kenya, Somalia and Sudan, the breeding season is slightly different because of the uniformity of the daylight length and depends on the rainfall. The follicular dynamics in the camel. Follicular growth occurs in camels during the breeding season. Follicular growth is continuous during the season and follicular activity continues in presence of an active CL. Studies utilizing ultrasound evaluations suggest that the growth phase in the camel is 10 days, the mature phase is 7 to 8 days, and the regression phase is around 12 days. Follicular growth depends on mating. There is no luteal phase in non-mated camels. In mated non-pregnant camels, the luteal phase is short, 6 to 9 days. The follicular recruitment requires 2 to 4 days, the growth 10 to 12 days, and dominance occurs at 6 mm. Now, a speciality of the camel is that follicles ovulate at 9 to 10 mm and no follicle about 2 to 2.5 cm ovulates. The ovulation is induced and no ovulation occurs in the absence of a mating. The fate of dominant follicle in absence of mating is an ovulatory follicle which may become hemorrhagic and may persist for many days and regress in 4 to 18 days. The follicular growth can occur in presence of an anovulatory follicle. This is again very peculiar in the female camel. This shows the fate of the dominant follicle in a non-mated camel. There is an anovulatory follicle, it regresses and goes down, and camel returns to estrus very shortly. Whereas in mated camels, there is formation of a CL, there is LH in response to a mating, and then there is formation of a CL, and there is increase in the plasma progesterone for a few days, followed thereby, if the animal has not become pregnant, again there will be another follicular growth and mating will result into formation of a CL. So camel reproduction is something different from most other domestic animal species. The estrocytes are strong in 55 to 60% of the camels, chasing other females, swelling of the vulva, receptivity towards a male, restlessness, bleating, up and down movement of the tail on approach of a male, and spraying of urine using the tail. The camel kneels down in front of a male camel. The male camel, it extrudes out this soft palate known as the dulla, and then the male camel may sniff the female and evidence the phlegmon response. Here in these two pictures you can see the camel evidencing the phlegmon response. Here you can see when in front of a male, the female sits down ready to be mated. The male then adopts the mating stance, which is usually the sitting position, and the female and the male may bite each other, and then mating occurs in a sitting position. Again, these are the photographs showing you the mating in the camel species. This is the mating in the Bactrian camel, and these three are in the dromedary camels. Now, hand mating was reported to be the predominant method practice, mating method practice. The mean ratio of camel females to a camel bull during the mating season was 47.8 cows per bull. The mean length of mating was 26.3 minutes. The ovulation is induced in response to a mating and occurs 24 to 30 hours after the mating. The follicle grows to ovulatory size in 6 days, and inter-estrus intervals in non-pregnant mated camels is 13 to 14 days. The estrogen peaks at estrus and progesterone rises after mating and peaks 6 days later. The embryo descends in the uterus at day 6 to 7 of mating. The embryo elongates at day 9 to 10. The implantation in the camel is not clearly known, but it's presumed that it occurs at around day 20. Then a specialty of the camel reproduction is the exclusive left uterine horn pregnancy. Even if the ovulation has occurred in the right ovary, the embryo is formed in the right uterine horn, it will migrate to the left uterine horn for establishment of the pregnancy. Migration of the embryos occurs at day 15 to 18 post-breeding. Then there are differences in the luteolytic properties of the prostaglandin from the left and the right uterine horns. The prostaglandin from the left uterine horn is known to cause the luteolysis of the CL both on the left and the right ovaries, whereas the prostaglandin from the right uterine horn is going to cause the luteolysis only of the CL on the right ovary. The gestation length in camels is very long, 315 to 440 days have been reported. The twins are exceptionally rare. The pregnancy diagnosis in camels, most of the breeders, they perform the pregnancy diagnosis on the basis of a peculiar behavior by the pregnant female camel, and that is the cocking of the tail. A pregnant camel will show it by lifting and curving her tail, which is known as the tail cocking, when a male camel advances towards her, first seen at 16 to 17 days of gestation. Here you can see the female camel lifting her tail in the presence of a male, and sometimes even it shows cocking in the presence of a owner of the camel when he approaches. The cocking would continue to for the for the most of the gestation period, and this is considered by camel breeders to be a perfect sign of pregnancy in the female camel. Then transrectal palpation can be performed in camels in a sitting position. Camels can be restrained like this. Both the hind legs and the forelegs are tied together separately, and female camels can be palpated like this. At some places where the camels, dromedary camels, are slightly shorter in height, they can be put into a specially built travis, and palpation can be done in a standing position. For the examination of the camel, xylogen at the dose rate of 0.5 to 2 mg per kg has to be administered intravenously so that the camel calms down, and this is evident by loss of the lower lip tone. Then transrectal ultrasonography can be used for pregnancy diagnosis in the female camels. Again, it has to be done in a sitting position, and this one is from the National Research Center on Camel at Bikaner, this one is from the Camel Reproduction Center at United Arab Emirates. Ultrasonography, one can detect the fluid, and then the embryo itself, the embryonic heartbeat, and then subsequently is similar to pregnancy in other species. The artificial insemination in camel has not become popular because of difficulty in identifying the trait which need to be propagated, but it's nowadays becoming popular in the Arab world. The semen collection can be done in sitting position using different methods, but the artificial vagina used for cattle has been used successfully in the female dromedary camel. The here you can see a female camel or a dummy can be used, and as soon as the camel tries to intromission, for one has to use the AV and guide the penis of the male camel into the artificial vagina. The camel semen has a thick gel. This is a big problem, and one need to liquefy this gel by keeping it at room temperature or maybe at 36 degree or 37 degree centigrade, sometimes even up to 6 hours. And once this gel liquefies, then one can identify the spermatozoa. Otherwise, it's very difficult to see anything in the semen collected from a male camel. Then embryo transfer in camel has been performed in the Arab world by Yagil, then in UAE by Skidmore, Mackinon, Enauzi, Wani and Negi, and India it has been done by Dr. Vyas and his associates. The superovulatory protocols in camels include the induction of the luteal phase by administration of HCG, and then on day 6 to 8 the superovulatory protocol can be started. Mating is essentially given on 36, 48 and 60 hours after the last FSH, and recipients are given a HCG on day 13 to 14 to synchronize them for transfer of the embryos. The camel embryos become filamentous after hatching of the blastocyst, and they are very difficult to be identified. Non-surgical embryo flushing is usually done on day 7 or 8, and a 18 gauze 63 centimeter flexible two-way Foley catheter used for equines can be used for camels. 1700 to 1800 ml of DPBS may be required, and then is passed through a MCON embryo filter and searched under a microscope. So this was all about that. Now we come to discuss about the infertility in the camels. Infertility in camels is less prevalent. clinical findings in female camels examined by Ali, it has shown that clinical endometritis is the most prevalent problem, followed by ovarian hydrobursitis, vaginal adhesions, cervical stenosis, cervical adhesions, anovulatory follicles, inactive ovaries, hydrosalpinx, uterine adhesions, persistent hymen, vulvar atresia, and pelvic abscess. The repeat bleeding syndrome in camels, the fertilization rates are 80 to 85% in camels. A repeat breeder syndrome is generally defined as any camel that failed to conceive after at least 3 regular spaced services with no clinical abnormalities. The causes could be improper breeding management, ovulation failures, or inability to complete the mating. Ovarian cysts are uncommon in camels in India and Pakistan, but they have been seen in camels raised in the United Arab Emirates. Here you can see an ultrasound picture of a ovarian cyst. Again, this cyst has the echogenic specks after a certain time period, and female camels with ovarian cysts may secrete progesterone, and these camels confuse the breeders for the camels to be pregnant, because such camels, they evidence cocking of their tails. Then ovarian hydrobursitis, vaginal septa, persistent hymen, and vaginal adhesions can be seen in camels. The persistent hymen, vaginal vulvar atresia, and vaginal adhesions are the second most common problem with poor prognosis. Bleeding at mating is the usual complaint of the owners, and surgical correction with proper instruments is possible. Vaginitis and vaginal tumors are rare in the camel. The cervical and uterine congenital malformations are rare. Cervicitis associated with metritis and endometritis have been seen. Metritis and clinical endometritis is the commonest problem. Uterine lavage or infusion of antibiotics, lotagen, have been suggested. Then pyometra and mucometra has been recorded in camels. Now, hydrobursitis is the most common ovarian problem in camels, breeding camels, and thought to be because of the chlamydophila abortus and E. coli. The surgical removal of a hydrobursitis by flank laparotomy is suggested if the condition is unilateral. Post-operative fertility has been reported to vary from 40 to 50%. Hydrobursitis frequently creates confusion among the novice examiners, because they will find plenty of fluid and they will confuse it with a pregnancy. Here you can see this is a hydrobursitis, plenty of fluid is accumulated, and this is the ovary, plenty of fluid around the ovary, and this creates confusion to the novice examiners for pregnancy in the camel. The refused mating syndrome, in this syndrome, female curls her tail dorsally when approached by a male, and this is a problematic condition in the female camels. Then abortions in camels can occur because of trypanosoma evansi, because that causes high temperatures, poor body condition, and may result into abortions. Other causes of abortions in camels could be brucella, leptospira, chlamydophila, toxoplasma, and twins. There is a strict vigilance on the monitoring of brucellosis in the Arab world, and the camels found to be positive for brucellosis are sent to the slaughterhouse. So, thank you very much. Kindly share the video and subscribe to my channel, Govind Narayan Purohit, if you like them. Thank you.